हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ मिस्टर आकाश वसन नेसरकर, लेक्चरर इन केमिस्ट्री, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, KLS गुप्ते PU कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, बेलगावी। स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर लास्ट वीडियो वी स्टडीड अबाउट द मैग्नेटिज्म इन सॉलिड्स and also discuss some problems on density of a solid. In today's session, we'll discuss more problems regarding the density of a solids, and also we'll see some important 2 marks and 3 marks question related to this topic. So let us start. A unit cell of a sodium chloride has 4 formula units. The edge length of the unit cell is 0.564 nanometer. What is the density of a sodium chloride? In the given problem, the edge length of the unit cell is given, that is 0.564 nanometer. The very important thing you have to remember while solving the density problem, that is conversion. The conversion of the edge length. If the edge length is given in terms of nanometer or in terms of picometer or angstrom, that we have to convert into centimeter. So right now, the edge length of the unit cell is given in a nanometer. And we know that 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to minus 9 meter and is equal to 10 raised to minus 7 centimeter. So first thing is what? We have to convert the edge length in terms of centimeter. Later on, find out the value of Z. The unit cell of sodium chloride has 4 formula units. It indicates that the value of Z is equal to 4, and therefore it is having face center cubic unit cell. So the value of Z is also given, that is Z is equal to 4. And we know that Avogadro value, that is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 gram per mole. And the molecular mass of a sodium chloride, it is 58.5 gram per mole. Now all these value we have to put into density formula, that is D is equal to Z into M divided by A raised to cube N subscript A. Put all these values in this formula. Upon simplification, we get the answer, that is 2.16 gram per centimeter cube. So the density of a sodium chloride is 2.165 gram per centimeter cube. In examination, sometimes they may twist the question. So not every time they will ask the problems on a density. Sometimes they twist the question and they ask to find out the edge length of the unit cell and also the molecular mass of the element or the molecular mass of the formula. So let us study such type of problems, which are very important for the examination. A body centered cubic element having density 10.3 gram per centimeter cube has an edge length of 314 picometer. Calculate the atomic mass of the element. So in this given problem, the density of the element is given, that is 10.3 gram per centimeter cube. Also they have given the edge length of the element, that is 314 picometer. Also the Avogadro number is given to you. Now you need to find out the value of M. So the cubic crystal is of body center cube, and therefore when the crystal is of BCC, then the value of Z is equal to 2. We know that because in body center cubic unit cell, the total number of particle is 2. So the value of z is equal to 2. And the value of A, that is edge length, it is given in terms of picometer, that is 10 raised to minus 12 meter. Now this also we have to convert in terms of centimeter, and therefore we get the final answer, that is 3.14 into 10 raised to minus 8 centimeter. Now these all values we have to substitute in the density formula, and upon simplification we get the answer, that is m is equal to 96.01 unit. So here in this formula the density is given to you and we need to find out the molecular mass. So by using this formula we have to shift the factors of the denominator into left hand side in order to calculate the value m. So m is equal to d into a cube na upon z. So this is the formula. So we have to rearrange the formula in order to calculate the molecular mass, or also sometime they may ask to find out the edge length. So that time also you have to rearrange the formula. So upon rearranging the formula, we get the value of m, also we get the value of a. So sometime they may twist the question in this manner. So be careful and read the problem twice. Now third one. Calcium metal crystallizes in a face-centered cubic lattice with edge length of 0.556 nanometer. Calculate the density of the metal. So here they have asked straightforward to calculate the density of the metal. So which is the metal? Calcium is the metal, and it is having face-centered cubic unit cell. So the value of z is equal to 4. The edge length A is equal to 0.556 into 10 raised to minus 9 meter. So it is given in terms of nanometer. So it is 10 raised to minus 9 meter. And they have asked to calculate the density. So first thing is what? We need to convert the nanometer in terms of a centimeter. So that is 5.56 into 10 raised to minus 8. So substitute all these values in this formula. Upon simplification, we get the answer, that is D is equal to 1.54 gram per centimeter cube. So the density of the calcium, it is 1.54 gram per centimeter cube. So remember students, such type of problems will come in the examination for 2 marks. And if you write the formula with the correct substitution, you will get 1 mark. And the final answer with the correct unit, that is gram per centimeter cube, you will get another mark. So total, the problem carries 2 marks and it is very important for the final examination. So be careful while converting the conversion, that is from nanometer to centimeter, picometer to centimeter and angstrom to centimeter. So this step is very important because maximum students will get fail in this conversion. And therefore, it is very important to convert the nanometer in terms of centimeter and the picometer in terms of a centimeter only. Now let us discuss few 2 marks question which are important in this topic. The very first one is what? How crystalline solids differ from amorphous solids in their melting point? So first try to understand what is the question, what they have asked. How crystalline solids differ from amorphous solids in their melting point? So we have to mention the difference of crystalline and amorphous solids regarding their melting point. So we know that, we already learned, crystalline solids have a sharp melting point, whereas amorphous solids do not have sharp melting point. And this answer depends upon their arrangement, because crystalline solid have regular arrangement and amorphous solids have irregular arrangement. So straightforward, you need to write down the answer in this fashion, that is crystalline solids have sharp melting point whereas amorphous solids do not have sharp melting point. If you write this much, you will get the 2 marks. The second question. Write any two differences between the crystalline solids and the amorphous solid. So this is very easy question. So you need to make two columns. In the first column you write crystalline solid, in the second column you write amorphous solid. At least two differences you have to mention. So here we have mentioned four differences. So at least for 2 marks we have to mention two differences. So in a crystalline solid, we know that it is having 3D long range orderly arrangement of a particle, whereas amorphous solid, no orderly arrangement of a constituent particle is present. Crystalline solids have sharp melting point, whereas amorphous solids do not have sharp melting point. Whereas crystalline solids are true solid, amorphous solids are pseudo solids. Crystalline solids are anisotropic in nature and amorphous solids are isotropic in nature. So the question is very easy. Okay, just remember the answer. The third one, what is meant by anisotropy? Question mark. What type of solid show this nature? So this is very important thing. Sometimes they may ask the anisotropic nature and also the isotropic nature. So don't get confused between this. Anisotropic, the crystalline solid. Isotropic is an amorphous solid. So what is mean by that anisotropic? So the answer is the physical properties like refractive index, coefficient of thermal expansion, when measured in a different direction, gives a different values for a crystalline solid, and hence it is anisotropic in nature. And the solid which shows the anisotropic nature is a crystalline solid. So only crystalline solid will show the anisotropic nature, not an amorphous solid. The fourth question, what are the nature of a particles and the force of attraction between the particles in non-polar molecular solid? So in the given question, they have asked regarding the nature of particles and the force of attraction present in a non-polar molecular solids. So the answer is, in a non-polar molecular solid, the constituent particles are non-polar, that is H2Cl2I2, even the atoms like argon, neon, xenon, etc. The nature of force of attraction is what? Dispersion force or the London force. So in a non-polar molecules, the dispersion force and the London force are present. The fifth one, what are the nature of particles and the force of attraction between the particles in polar molecular solids? And the answer is, in polar molecular solids, the constituent particles are formed by polar covalent bond like HCl, that is hydrogen chloride, and SO2, that is sulfur dioxide. The nature of force of attraction is dipole-dipole attraction. So remember guys, if it is a polar molecular solid, then dipole-dipole attraction is present, and if it is a non-polar, then dispersion and London force is present. So these two are very important. The sixth one, what are the nature of particles and the force of attraction between the particles in hydrogen bonded molecular solids? So the answer is, in a hydrogen bonded molecular solid, the constituent particles are polar molecules capable of forming the hydrogen bond like water. The nature of the force of attraction is what? Hydrogen bond. So between these type of particle, the hydrogen bond is present. So the force of attraction is itself a hydrogen bonding. And we know that hydrogen bond is present between one highly electronegative element, that is oxygen or nitrogen, with that of a hydrogen. So that is called as a hydrogen bonding. Seventh one, what are point defects? Mention the types. Point defects are the irregularities in the arrangement of the constituent particle around a point or a lattice site in a crystalline substance. These are of three types: stoichiometric defect, non-stoichiometric defect, and the imperfect defect. Next question. Classify the following into polar and non-polar molecular solids: argon, hydrogen chloride, I2, and sulfur dioxide. Among these four, we have to identify which are polar and non-polar molecular solid. So it's very easy, guys. Just look at argon and I2. Both are non-polar, therefore they are non-polar molecular solid, whereas HCl and sulfur dioxide, the electronegativity difference is present, and therefore those are polar molecular solids. So it's quite easy. If the electronegativity difference is present, then it is polar molecular solid. If electronegativity difference is not present, then it is non-polar molecular solid. Now next one, calculate the number of particles present per unit cell in a FCC unit cell. So such type of questions, that is to calculate the number of particles present in the FCC, BCC or simple cube, it is repeatedly asked in a final examination. So you have to focus on this question more. So the answer, contribution of corner particles is equal to 8 into 1 by 8 is equal to 0.1. Contribution of particles at the center of phase is equal to 6 into 1 by 2 is equal to 3, and the total number of particles per unit cell is equal to 4. So if you write down the answer in this fashion, then only you will get 2 marks. If you write down the direct answer, that is number of particles or unit cell is equal to 4, then you will get only 1 mark. So you have to show the calculation of a corner particle as well as the center of a phase particle, then only you will get the 2 marks. Got it? The next question, calculate the number of particles present per unit cell in a BCC unit cell. We know that in case of body center cubic unit cell, the one particle is present at the body of a unit cell which is not shared by the 8 corner particles. So the answer is, contribution of corner particle is equal to 8 into 1 by 8 is equal to 0.1. Contribution of particle at the center is 1 into 1 is equal to 1. So the total number of particle oblique unit cell is equal to 0.2. So there are 2 particles present per unit cell in body center cubic unit cell. And the last one, calculate the number of particle present per unit cell in a simple cubic unit cell. So we know that in a simple cubic unit cell, there are 8 corner particles. So the contribution of corner particles are 8 into 1 by 8 is equal to 0.1. Therefore, total number of particles oblique unit cell is equal to 0.1. So in the similar problems, there are more questions. So I am not going to discuss these problems. You just take down the screenshot and make an assignment of this. Okay. So I will give you the 3 seconds. You better take down the screenshot. The next questions, please take the screenshot, guys. Now, in this slide, we are having the questions for a 3 marks. So for 3 marks question, the packing efficiency of simple cubic unit cell, or the packing efficiency of body center cubic unit cell, or the packing efficiency of simple cubic. These are important questions for the final examination. So how to calculate that? It is given in this slide. You just take a screenshot and make a note in our assignment. So please guys, take the screenshot. The second one is, calculate the packing efficiency in phase center cubic unit cell. So in a phase center cubic unit cell, the packing efficiency is 74%. So you need to write down all these things in order to get a 3 marks. So the 3 marks are very important. Next, calculate the packing efficiency in body center cubic unit cell. So we know that in case of body center cubic unit cell, the packing efficiency is 68%. So better take the screenshot and make a note of this later on. fourth one, based on the band theory, explain the conduction in metal, insulator and semiconductors. So this is very easy. Based on the band theory, you have to explain what is conduction in metals, insulators and semiconductors. The seventh one, what are diamagnetic and paramagnetic and ferrimagnetic substances with the example. So guys, take a screenshot of this slide and make a note of these all questions, and that will be your assignment. So here I will declare that the topic is completed, and for more questions and answer, refer the site, that is www.pue.kar.nic.in. And if you have any doubt, then you can contact me or message me on my WhatsApp number, or you can meet me in a college. So thank you.